This problem illustrates how the how your problem 1-1a will work. It's the same set of concepts with a few different numbers and a couple of twists for you. What we do is we set up a set of accounts with the assets on the left and then the liabilities and owner's equity on the right. Assets are things we own, cash. Accounts receivable, which is a promise that somebody's made to pay us. That's an asset. We can actually sell that promise to somebody else. And supplies. Pencil, paper, oil, sandpaper, you name it. On the other side of the equation, we have accounts payable or liabilities, a promise we've made to pay someone else. We owe them that money. And then we have the owner's equity accounts. The capital account represents money that Mr. Eisen has contributed to the company, or the net earnings that he's earned as the company's grown. Since this is a brand new company and he's just setting it up, there are no earnings. Drawings, Brett Eisen drawing, represents withdrawals that he might make. And then we have some temporary accounts, revenue accounts. Revenues represent fees or other monies that we've earned by doing whatever it is the company does. And then expenses represent costs that we've incurred in order to generate these revenues. The definition of an expense is usually considered the wasting away or the consuming of an asset to generate revenues. So the first transaction initiates the company. And Mr. Eisen contributes $30,000 from his personal money to a company account. So the company debits cash or increases cash. And let me go back to debits just a second. Debits and credits. A debit is on the left and a credit is on the right. Assets are always increased by debits and they're decreased by credits. Liabilities, owner's equity, and revenues, those three types of accounts, all are increased by credits. Drawing and expenses are increased by debits. So you can see if you have a credit over here, say for, let's say fees earned, you have a credit for fees earned of $10,000, and then you have a rent expense of $5,000, which was a debit, you would net the two out and you'd have net income of $5,000. But in this case, cash is debited or increased by $30,000. Capital is credited or increased by $30,000. And the equation balances. Everything on the right-hand side of the equation is owner's equity or a liability. Everything on the left-hand side of the equation is an asset. Remember, everything we see here in yellow is going to be an asset of some kind. Everything we see here in blue, if it shows up, everything we see here in blue is going to be a liability or some kind of owner's equity. Capital and fees earned are increases to owner's equity. Drawing and expenses are decreases to owner's equity. So the second transaction is $1,200 was promised to some vendors. We promised to pay them $1,200 and they gave us supplies for our supply closet to the tune of $1,200. You notice that Mr. Eisen doesn't own those supplies. He has promised to pay someone else, so we've increased the right-hand side of the equation not through owner's equity, but through a liability, a promise to pay someone else. He has to pay those people that $1,200. He can't draw $31,200 out of the company. He can draw $30,000 out of the company, but the $1,200 he owes to the suppliers. The next part of the equation, the next transaction, is $7,200, which was earned, and the customers paid us in cash, paid the company in cash. So we debit cash for $7,200, increasing cash. We credit fees earned for $7,200, increasing fees earned. In the next part of the equation, we pay other people. We paid rent expense. We decreased cash, by $3,000, and we incurred an expense which decreases owner's equity. You notice that the parentheses indicates a decrease of something. This is an actual decrease to cash. This is an increase to an expense, but an expense, as it goes up, decreases owner's equity. So I know that sounds confusing right now, but we've debited an expense account for $3,000. We've credited cash. Remember I said that cash is increased by debit, and or assets are increased by debits and decreased by credits. And here's an example of that. Cash here, an asset, has been decreased by paying a landlord $3,000. We have increased the rent expense by $3,000, a debit to an expense account, which decreases owner's equity. The next is another occurrence of cash being paid out, but this time we paid some of those suppliers that we promised to pay. We paid them $750, leaving a balance now that we owe of $450. Decrease cash, decrease liability. We ought to go back to that, I guess, since an assets are decreased by credits, liabilities are decreased by debits. In this case, we've debited a liability and credited cash. The next one is $5,000 of fees earned, but we didn't get the money right away. People promised to pay us, and so that's an accounts receivable, a promise that they will pay us in the future. Debit assets and credit fees earned. Here we have $900 being paid for two different expenses, automobile expenses and miscellaneous expenses. So we have debited the expense accounts, which decreases owner's equity. We have credited the cash account, which decreases assets. Here we have decreased cash again by paying salaries. Again, an asset is decreased, owner's equity is decreased by incurring an expense. And then finally here, we have another situation. We bought $1,200 worth of supplies beginning early in the month, but we check our closet at the end of the month and we realize that we only have $700 worth of supplies left in there, so we must have used $500. So we recognize that $500 of this asset has been consumed in generating revenues, and we debit the supplies expense for $500, decreasing owner's equity. We credit the asset supplies for $500, which decreases this side of the equation. Remember, we're decreasing owner's equity over here, decreasing assets over here. Now, finally, Mr. Eisen withdraws $1,500 from the company. Debit to drawing, decreasing owner's equity. A credit to cash, decreasing the assets. If we add up all the balances on the left-hand side, it should equal the balances of everything on the right-hand side. Assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity. Owner's equity is represented by all these accounts over here. So let's look and see. These are the revenues and expenses. If we add the revenues and subtract all the expenses from it, we should get net income. If the expenses are greater than the revenue, it'll be a net loss, but let's look. $12,200 minus all the expenses ends up as $6,000 in net income. The company has earned income of $6,000. Then we have owner's equity, which is the capital account and the drawing account, and maybe I should call it the capital, the net capital contributed minus capital withdrawn is $28,500. And finally, we add up all the liabilities, which I can do in my head because it's actually one line, $450. That's the liabilities. Now we add up the assets, $34,950. And we check and see if they balance. And sure enough, the liabilities plus owner's equity ends up being $34,950. Use the same process to complete problem 1-1A, please, and make sure you can do that. We'll do something similar in class, but this is your first problem in accounting. Have a good day and good luck.